तो
So we can go ahead.
नमस्ते, गुड इवनिंग। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ इंडिया टूरिज्म मुंबई, द रीजनल ऑफिस ऑफ मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ टूरिज्म इन द वेस्टर्न रीजन, आई इनवाइट यू टू दिस स्पेशल वेबिनार टाइटल्ड गोवर्धन इको विलेज कैटलिस्ट फॉर रूरल डेवलपमेंट। बिफोर वी स्टार्ट, लेट मी शेयर सम रेगुलर हाउसकीपिंग अनाउंसमेंट। प्लीज कीप योर ऑडियो म्यूटेड, ऑल्सो द वीडियो मे बी ऑन द ऑफ मोड so as to ensure good bandwidth, and you all your questions you can put it in the chat box and this will be taken up at the end of the session. With this, I extend my warm greetings to warm greetings for the World Tourism Day to all of you who have joined us today. This year may have changed our ability to travel across the globe, but our desire to experience new culture, see far off places, or discover hidden gems in our own backyard has not diminished. As we celebrate World Tourism Day today with the theme of tourism and rural development, we chose to conduct this webinar titled Govardhan Eco Village, a Catalyst for Rural Development, to recognize the unique role that tourism plays in providing opportunities outside big cities and preserving culture and natural heritage. Situated in the beautiful mountain ranges of Sahyadri, Govardhan Eco Village is a testament to the powers of Ayurveda, yoga, and meditation to bring about transformative change. It is led by principles of humility and sustainability, and its mission is to serve and propagate the benefits of India's age-old tradition to the whole world. The Govardhan Eco Village, through its various activities focusing on empowerment of farmers, healthcare for local villagers, water resource development, women empowerment, skill development, hunger eradication, rural education, etc., has truly become a catalyst for rural development through tourism in the neighborhood of Mumbai in the village of Wada. In fact, Govardhan Eco Village in 2017 won the UNWTO award for innovation in the category of non-governmental organizations, the highest honor given to an NGO for shaping global tourism through sustainable innovative initiatives. We are honored today to have the presence of Sri Gauranga Dasji, director of the Govardhan Eco Village, to talk about the philosophy and journey of creation of the Govardhan Eco Village, followed by a presentation by Mr. Vikas Purohit, who is the general manager of the Govardhan Eco Village. He will be talking about the experience for tourists with respect to programs, packages, and facilities. Especially for those of you who are joining in from Mumbai, this is a very ideal destination, very close to Mumbai, almost 100 kilometers, and is an amazing setting, very close almost on the laps of the nature. Let me now introduce our speakers. Sri Gauranga Dasji, in last 3 decades of his life journey, has touched and transformed countless lives through his activities and different roles he has been adapting to drive the change in society. He is a mindful leadership consultant and is running initiatives related to meditation, yoga, and preventive de-addiction, thus empowering thousands of youth to positively transform their lives. He has established the Govardhan School of Public Leadership in Govardhan Eco Village, which is involved in training future bureaucrats and public leaders in responsible, mindful leadership with character and integrity based on principle of Bhagavad Gita. As a social reformer, he is facilitating transformation in the lives of tribal villagers around the eco village through various social and economic interventions. Under his guidance, the eco village won more than 30 awards, including the UNWTO award, which I had mentioned earlier. Prabhuji is an inspirational speaker for his expertise of presenting Vedic knowledge in a contemporary and enticing way. He has spoken in various conferences like TEDx and to the corporates like Intel, Salesforce, Google, etc. He is also involved in the leadership and organizational development of ISKCON organization in various capacities, including being a trustee of the ISKCON Leadership College, Global Duty Officer of ISKCON, and divisional director of devotee care, temple development system and administration of ISKCON temples worldwide. In fact, he is a BTech from IIT Mumbai, Bombay. He is also a great cook and has cooked over 3 million plates in the period of 2007 to 19. And recently during the COVID pandemic, he along with his team in the Eco Village cooked over 100,000 meal to feed the migrant laborers. Sri Vikas Purohitji is the general manager of the Govardhan Eco Village. And he also has a unique opportunity of having worked in various fields of service industry, traditional institutional marketing, supply chain management, and department licensing. With this, now I open the screen, a space for Gauranga Prabhuji to take us through the journey of the Eco Village and tell us more about this wonderful place on earth. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Venkateshan ji and your team, for inviting us to present on the World Tourism Day. A very happy World Tourism Day to all of our partners, friends, well-wishers who are here. Govardhan Eco Village, a catalyst for rural development. Next. Next slide. Yeah, you can go through the whole thing. Fill up the whole slide, yeah. So Govardhan Eco Village was set up in 2003. And the main idea was to create a balance of the human being with respect to himself, with the divine and with nature. And therefore, we found that India has a population of 130 crore, out of which around 80 crore are living in villages, in more than 600 to 700,000 villages. And migration is a huge problem. And India has one of the largest populations of farmers in the whole world. Farming is one of the topmost occupations of people here in India. But we find that typical tendency of farmers is they want their children to move to the cities. And the tendency towards migration is very strong. And therefore, we thought, is there a way by which we can connect the city to the village? Because city people don't want to go to the villages. So therefore, one of the biggest challenges people in cities are facing is distraction and anxiety and stress. 370 people in India commit suicide every single day. We have 300 million people across the world experiencing the huge problem of stress, anxiety, and various disorders related to that. And therefore, people are looking for peace in the city, and people in the villages are looking for economic development. So we thought, let us create a model which will connect the needs of the city folks for peace with the needs of the village folks for engagement and employment and economy by creating a hub and a spoke model in the midst of a tribal district of Palghar. So, next slide. We are basically 100 kilometers away from Mumbai, and we thought, let us try to focus on four human needs which anybody has: ecological, economical, social, and cultural. And so we created over 100 acres Govardhan Eco Village, which is considered to be a hub and spoke model, which means that we create certain very, very benchmarking activities on how we can live in harmony with oneself. People coming from the city in anxiety and stress can actually transform themselves through Ayurveda, yoga, spirituality. And the 100 rupees which they spend here at the Govardhan Eco Village, we spend at least 30 rupees in rural development around us. And therefore, we decided to create a unique smart village model where S stands for stability or satisfaction of the villager in the rural area, because the biggest challenge facing India today is rural population is dissatisfied and they want to leave the village. And therefore, S stands for stability and satisfaction. M stands for morality. We try to share with people the moral principles which we have so that they can actually live in harmony with themselves. A stands for ability. We try to help improve the ability of the villagers by creating farmer development, women empowerment, self-help groups, by creating school education for children, especially by having midday meals distributed and arresting the dropout rates. And most importantly, health through various public health centers and also by having mobile clinics and having various camps. And in this way, by adding to the ability of the people today in India, parents do not want their children to become either farmer, teacher, or soldier. And this is a very worrying trend. So therefore, ISKCON is at the very forefront trying to provide some kind of a model in rural areas so that the farmers can experience transformation through the rural development program. And therefore, after spending their time at the eco-village being transformed through Ayurveda and yoga, when people are peaceful and satisfied, they say, is there anything you are doing in the nearby community? And we say, yes, we are engaged in Govardhan Rural Development. You can come and see what we are doing. So they become partners for all of us for rural development. They either contribute their ideas or their contacts or their knowledge of different schemes or technology or through their CSR. And in this way, we have created a model where a village has become accessible to the city people, because unless there is an airport and unless there is a proper tarmac or a runway, the flight cannot land. So people from the city, especially the kids, are so afraid of staying in a raw village. We created city comfort in a village where you are coming from different sophisticated cities can land there, then stay in our comfortable air-conditioned rooms, about which Mr. Vikas will speak more details, and then come around and try to support the rural development activities. So this comes in the category of either what you call as rural tourism or agritourism, responsible tourism, sustainable tourism, yoga tourism, whatever names you want to give, all of these can apply here. Go ahead. So therefore, eco-village design is about creating an ecosystem for life. Go ahead, next. So one of the biggest challenges we had was how we can make tourism in such a way that we are not adding to further waste. Next. And so we decided that just like the nature is cyclic in nature, cycle moves in nature, like that we should have in such a way that every waste in one system becomes the input for another system. If you could design things like that, then we would have a zero waste eco-village, a tourist destination which is zero waste with minimum carbon footprint, which will actually be a Vedic example of climate change adaptation. Next. And therefore, what? Yes. So one of the biggest challenges the world is facing is resources are depleting, wastes are increasing. You may be aware that we have only coal, natural oil, and natural gas resources for the next 50 to 100 years only. And therefore, the design challenge was how we can create the design in such a way that the resource of the first system, rather than becoming a waste, becomes a contributor. And the waste from the first system becomes a resource of the second system. Waste from the second system becomes a resource for the third system. And in this way, rather than having a linear resource to trash model, we thought, let us have a symbiotic recycling concept where each system becomes an individual contributor. Go ahead. Therefore, in this figure, you see that the cow is happy eating the grass and giving dung. Cow and grass can live happily ever after, but when human beings come in, they need a place to stay. So therefore, that dung is fertilizing and creating, you know, crops. The crops need to be eaten, but then human beings need a place to stay. So using bricks, mud bricks, we create dwellings. Using biogas, we create fire. Then what waste comes out after eating the food that is processed in what you see on the right-hand corner is a soil biotechnology plant, a green design patented by IIT Mumbai, created by Dr. Biplab Patnaik and Professor S. Shankar for processing all the waste in a natural way. We create 4 crore liters of water from the sewage, which is processed like this. And then again, that water goes in again. And in this way, we have a cyclical nature modeling system. Next. Therefore, eco-village construction is not about creating buildings, but creating living spaces. Next. Therefore, what you see here is known as compressed stabilized earth blocks, where we have only 7% cement, 3% limestone, then remaining is mud and we have the grit powder mixed together using a simple hand device, which is known as a mud block making machine. We have created, you will not believe, 500,000 bricks on site by training all the local people around. And we have created a complete training ecosystem. With this, if you compare with a brick wall with plaster and paint, it has 72 megajoules per kilogram embodied energy. Whereas a compressed stabilized earth blocks, it only has 0.275 megajoules per kilogram. What a huge amount of service we are doing to Bhumi Devi, Mother Earth, and mitigating climate change by using this. Plus, maintenance is another, you know, great advantage, that you don't have to repaint. You don't have to deal with the plaster. Whatever you see is the final look and feel. And another major advantage is that this wall is a breathing wall. So if you enter a room which is so friendly to human beings, so the health improves, overall night sleep improves, and most importantly, you are in a natural ambience, because the natural temperature drop in winter, in summer, is 5 to 6 degrees, and the heat in winter is also 5 to 6 degrees. So automatically you will see the effect of a breathing wall. Next. And therefore, this is how we have created by making first the proper zones, and then we use the compressed stabilized earth blocks and lower maintenance compared to the regular buildings. Next. This is how it looks. And Mr. Vikas will speak more about the interiors during his presentation. All the rooms are completely air conditioned. Next. Then the other challenge was water. So as all of us are aware, water is one of the biggest challenges the world is facing. And 97.5% of the world's water is in salt water. Only 2.5% is fresh water. Out of that 2.5%, you will not believe, 99.7% of that fresh water is in two spaces. Number one, majority, 67% plus, is in glaciers. And the remaining 23% is in underground aquifers. So what you see outside in form of rivers and lakes, my dear friends, you will not believe, is only 0.3% of that 2.5%. So therefore, when you look around traveling in trains and cars and you see lakes and rivers, you may think, "Arey, bahut pani hai dunia mein." But we have very limited supply. And therefore, in the 2030 SDG agenda, water is a major thing. And in future, water wars are going to happen. So if you do not plan for water, then your entire approach is irresponsible. Go ahead. Next. So the first thing we did was, what you see here is a hydrogeological survey to understand what is the topography of water under the ground. Just like X-ray reveals how your body parts are within your body, hydrogeological survey reveals how water is situated under the ground. So initially we did not have enough funds. So someone said, you bring one person from the village who will have a coconut. वो नारियल लेके घूमेगा और जहां पर पानी होगा नारियल घूमेगा वो 200 रुपए में काम हो जाएगा. बट आवर यू नो पर्सन आवर मेन आर्किटेक्ट शी वॉज वेरी यू नो फिक्स्ड ऑन द फैक्ट दैट नो वी हैव टू इन्वेस्ट इन दिस एंड दिस कॉस्ट इज 5 to 6 lakhs विद एक्वाडैम कंपनी फ्रॉम पूना. डॉक्टर हिमांशु कुलकर्णी इज अ वाटर एक्सपर्ट. ही आइडेंटिफाइड दैट दिस इज द प्लेस where you have to make the large rainwater harvesting tank. This is the place where groundwater aquifer should be recharged and things like that. You will not believe that over the last 9 years, our underground water level has grown up by 4 meters, because every year we have been recharging. Go to the next slide. And you see, this is the largest rainwater harvesting tank we have in the entire Palghar district. And thanks to the hydrogeological survey. Next. So not only that, this is how it was looking before and this is how it looks now. And then we have also the wells at the right places thanks to this. Next. Then comes the problem of waste. So we may think it is waste, but it is excess concentration of nutrients. Next. And what you see here is a soil biotechnology plant which uses simply water which is gravity driven through the sewerage system. It collects in the collection tank and then it is pumped on top of what looks like a garden. But this is, I am telling you, the most amazing natural sewage processing technology, with root bacteria of the plants, with all the various kinds of bioreactors and geophagous earthworms. The water which comes out is known as fish fit water. Every year we are processing 40 million liters of water like this, and then our farms are being irrigated through this. So every drop of our wastewater, black and gray water, which the guests are using either through flushing or their bathing, every drop of that water is harnessed, harvested, and again processed and used again for agriculture. So therefore, we are very conscious of the waste. And this is a patent of IIT Mumbai. Go ahead, next. And therefore, apart from that, the cement bags and others we are using in nursery, and the other food waste we are using is also composting. So overall, we have a zero waste system here with us. Next. Energy is also very important because we also depend on solar energy. Next. And therefore, we have solar plant. We have an animal driven prime mover, which you see below, animal bull based farming and biogas plant. These are the ways in which we are using the alternative energy, which is very, very important. So many times, you know, there was a very intellectual person from the city who went to the village, and he saw the farmer, you know, moving the bull around like this in one of the water pumps. He said, "Arey, what is this?" He heard the, you know, bells under the bull's neck hanging from a chain. So this intellectual said, "What is this bull doing?" So the farmer said, "Well, the bull is moving around and pumping water out." The intellectual said, "But, you know, why is there a bell around the bull's neck?" So the farmer said, "Well, if the bull stops working, then we'll come to know that the bull has stopped working because the tinkling of the bell will stop." So the intellectual looked at the farmer and said, "What if the bull stands at one place and shakes his head? Then also the bell will make a sound." So the farmer looked at the intellectual and said, "Sir, this is a bull and not an intellectual like you. He will not think like this." So therefore, the way city folks think, many times it becomes difficult to understand how the village functions. So therefore, it is very important to integrate the village thought process with what we are intervening next. And therefore, we have reached out to the villagers and made them part of our family. Go ahead. Next. And so we have engaged in what is known as a holistic rural development program centered around all of these amazing principles, because unless you make the villagers part of your life, you will not be able to see the difference. Next. So therefore, we have what is known as the Wadi Project, farming, organic manure, livestock development, 1300 plus farmers we have adopted. And all of these are part of our rural development scheme, 7,000 farmers trained, and so much of amazing work we are doing in all these places. So I want to share with all of you before I hand over to Mr. Vikas that tourism has a very important role to play in India today. And I am myself an IITian, and I am founder of an organization called IIT-IIT, which basically stands for IITians for Influencing India's Transformation. So Indians who understand English is only 8%, but it still translates to 100 million people. And therefore, in India today, 93% of Indians are in medium, small, enterprises, MSMEs. And therefore, in countries like Japan and Germany and South Korea, the Human Resource Development, Education and Skills Department is handled directly by the Deputy Prime Minister. They give it so much of importance. Just for an example, that 70 years ago, South Korea was poorer than India. Now, South Korea has $25,000 per capita as against India's $1,861 USD. which shows that some of our soft skills like yoga, Sanskrit, Ayurveda, wisdom, culture needs to be showcased to the world. And therefore, when there is a critical mass of discomfort and passion and enthusiasm for new things, then transformation will happen. So in India, in the age group of 1 to 35, 850 million people are there. Whereas in MSME, we are 430 million people, especially in agriculture, manufacturing, service, and an unemployment numbers in India is 300 million. And therefore, 71% of India, which is 840 million people, are under the age of 35, which is a huge opportunity for tourism industry. India's birth rate is approximately 28 million every year. Death rate is 10 million per annum. And therefore, the population is increasing at 1.6% per year. But the most shocking thing, which the tourism specialist should note, that you may not be aware that in the education system, 27 crore Indians are in first to 12th standard, from KG to 12th standard, 3 crore are in colleges. But in the kindergarten to 12th standard, 88% of the students drop out before they enter college. That means 12th standard in India is known as educational line of control, where only 12% of India students after the 12th standard enter into college, those who begin their first standard. And therefore, India has to focus on skills. And amongst 58,000 colleges, 62% are arts colleges, 38% are science and technology colleges and everything. But we need to focus on skills, and tourism is a huge opportunity. And therefore, Indian youth, across the world, if you see the skills, vocation, skills and trade, 3,000 courses are there in more than 15,000 modules for world youth in the age group of 15 to 35. 80% of the youth in the world in the age group of 15 to 35 are learning either vocation, skills or trades. Whereas in India, there are only 400 courses and only 3% of India's population in the age group of 15 to 35 is learning skills. This has to change. India is focusing on producing MBAs, engineers, but we do not have world-class carpenters, plumbers, drivers, repairmen. We have more than 2,500 vocations. The only vocation we have really focused on and done well is 80,000 private IT training centers, information technology. So, if you look at IT, information technology, it accounts for 2.5% of the world GDP, but 5% of India's GDP, actually. And therefore, we have to realize that we have to think of new employment generation options. The cities are becoming clogged. We have to look in the direction of the villages. And apart from agriculture, the huge opportunity in villages is tourism. And therefore, government has only 3% of the total employment. Organized sector has only 4%, but unorganized sector employs 93%. And therefore, this is a very, very important principle that, if you look at literacy rate, 600 million are illiterate if you consider the literacy to be up to class 5 pass. So below poverty line, India is having 300 million people by the definition of 26 rupees per day, 600 million people by the definition of 65 rupees per day, 900 million people by the definition of 128 rupees per day, which is the World Bank's new definition. And therefore, with 1.3 billion population, our average per capita after independence for so many years has grown only to 1861 US dollars per year with a $2 trillion economy. And average, earning per day comes out to six US dollars or 450 rupees. Whereas China in the same period has grown to 8,000 US dollars per capita and USA at 56,000 US dollars. And therefore, India has only 3% of the world GDP, but we have 17% of the world population. And people need to travel, people need to go. And therefore, India foreign trade share in 1000 AD, 1000 years ago, was 33%. In 1500 AD, it came down to 27%. In 1947, it came down to 3%. And today, it is at 2.2%. Dear friends, English is the language of only 30% of the world's GDP, whereas 70% of the world's GDP is produced by countries which do not have English as their main language. And therefore, we should not be stuck that only English is important, whereas we have so many varieties in India, dialects, languages, cuisines. India is actually the most attractive hotbed for tourism with 22 languages and 2,600 dialects. And therefore, we have to appreciate this fact that with 17% of the world's population, with only 2.2% of the land mass of the world, with 2.6% of the world GDP, with 2.2% of the global trade we have only 0.4% of foreign tourist arrivals of the world. This needs to change. And of course, I'm not talking about the COVID times, but later. And therefore, all of you as tourist professionals, tourism professionals, have a major role to play to transform India's economy, to transform the rural landscape in India, to create hope amongst the villagers. India has to increase its export by 10 times and tourism by 50 times in the next 20 years, by which I envisage 8 powerful impact will happen. 8 effects of increasing tourism by 50 times in the next 20 years would result in improvement in overall governance and administration, because we would have to cater to the best in the world. Second, the manufacturing and services sector will improve tremendously because you have to provide service. Third, there will be a cost competitive advantage that will also improve. Fourth, as the number of tourists grow, foreign direct investment FDI will increase. Currently, we have only 5% of the world's FDI. Fifth, the latest technology will come to India, because if you have to cater to the global population, the latest technology has to be prepared here. And then number six, very important, jobs will be created. And number seven, naturally, as tourism grows, infrastructure will have to improve. And therefore, the eighth advantage is, as a result, the standard of living will grow. So therefore, dear friends, let us realize that when the stock market crashed in the United States in 1930, you know, human capital accounted only for 10% of the market cap. Whereas in 2018, human capital accounted for 90% of the market cap. And therefore, the first essential of good governance is to improve the quality of effective human capital. And so IQ accounts for only 30% of what we are, whereas 70% of what we are and what our responses are will be defined by our spiritual quotient, by our emotional quotient, by our adversity quotient. And therefore, India is the place which is filled with knowledge, with information and techniques, including yoga and Ayurveda, on how to improve your mental strength and resilience to deal with adversity. And therefore, all of you who are professionals in tourism need to capitalize on the soft power which India has as a nation. We are proud of our country. We are proud of our nation. We are proud of our Honorable Prime Minister, who has made yoga a household name across the whole world by, you know, facilitating the United Nations to have June 21st as the International Day of Yoga. ISKCON has 700 centers all across the whole world. I am the Global Director for Temple Development Systems, and ISKCON would be more than happy to partner with India Tourism and various experts in tourism on how we can transform the millions of holy places in India as destinations of curiosity for fulfilling the knowledge requirement, because people in the West are not looking at India for just comfort. They are looking at India for something which India is offering: knowledge. That is our USP, wisdom. That is our USP. So the Govardhan Eco Village has been created on the pillar of three main pillars. Hinduism is called a way of life. So Govardhan Eco Village is also based on the way of life. W for wisdom, A for Ayurveda, Why for yoga? And we have recreated Vrindavan over 10 acres. So now over to you, Mr. Vikas, for taking this to the next level of discussion in a language which our various tourism experts will understand. Thank you very much, Mr. Venkateshan, and the tourism department for giving me this opportunity. Hare Krishna. You have to unmute yourself, Mr. Vikas.
So thank you so much, Prabhuji. So as you have seen till now, Gaurang Prabhu has explained about the philosophy, journey, creation, and the concept behind making of Govardhan Eco Village. Now we are going to see the other part of Govardhan Eco Village, that is Govardhan Retreat Center, what it is. Next, please.
Next.
So as already explained, it is basically a farm community and a retreat center, which includes temples, sacred temples, replica of Vrindavan forest, Ayurveda center, and many more. And location wise, if we see, it is located 90 kilometers to the north of Mumbai, to be very particular, on Gujarat highway, and very much at the foothills of Sahyadri mountains. Then it is spread over 100 acres of the area, and Govardhan Eco Village is serving, as already explained by Prabhuji, it is serving in various parts of like rural development, organic farming, cow protection, and many more. Next, please. So here I am going to explain what experience you will have once you visit Govardhan Eco Village, and about the facilities and packages we are going to offer for our guests to make their stay a wonderful experience at Eco Village. So when you visit Govardhan Eco Village, you will have an integrated experience for your mood, mind, body, and soul. How it is, we will see in next slides. Next, please. So if you are feeling stressed due to your hectic or busy city life, or now you must be feeling more stressed due to this long lockdown of more than 6 months being at home, so this is the right place you can visit, wherein you can come close to the nature, so that you can see, after coming close to the nature, you can see the greenery as it is surrounded by Sahyadri mountains and having a very much lush green campus, so that you can rejuvenate and refresh your mood. Next, please. Coming to the mind point, as per the recent survey of WHO, World Health Organization, it is said that in 21st century, the greatest disease is not a cancer or not AIDS, but it will be like mental stress or mental disorder. So to overcome this, by practicing yoga and meditation, you can have a peace of mind which you can experience when you come at Govardhan Eco Village. Next, please. So coming to the body, as we have Ayurveda retreat centers, and we are offering different packages which we will see in next slides. So as yoga is for body, your Ayurveda will work for relaxation of yourself and also to get rid of your body ailments. So we are taking care of your body as well when you visit here and stay with us. Next. So if you as we see about the soul, as you must have heard about, as food is the food for body is roti, or like you can say bread and butter. Then, but as per Gita, what it is said, that food for your soul is what? Connecting with God. And this may be the real meaning of yoga. So when you come here, and if you thrive deep into your inner nature, that too in close association with Vrindavan temples, whatever temples we have, sacred temples, then replica of Vrindavan forest, what we have developed, then Yamuna river is there, then you will be given wisdom talks by the spiritual or resident monks over here. So you will be having opportunity to rejuvenate your soul also. So we are, in this way, we are taking care of all your four aspects: mood, mind, body, and soul. You will have an integrated experience of these four. Next, please. So now we will see what are the facilities we are going to offer to our guests when they come and stay with us. So next, please. So as Prabhuji has also explained, we have brought, we have committed and we have offered, ensured to offer the city comforts in village, as Govardhan Eco Village is located very much in the rural area and in village area, but we have ensured to provide best possible luxury and comfort to our guest. So by providing comfortable and luxurious rooms, what we have different kind of cottages, like four cottages we have. Mahavan Cottage, all are named after different places of Vrindavan. Mahavan Cottage, Vrindavan Cottage, then Gokul Cottage, then Madhuvan Cottage. So all are luxurious air-conditioned rooms. Along with that, we provide 24/7 Wi-Fi facility to take care of their local conveyance, because area is too much spread over 100 acres. We are providing them electrical cards also. So all comforts we are providing here, being in village. Now, one can have the Swiss chalet experience also being in earlier slide. Yeah, one can have the Swiss chalet experience if you stay in our duplex bungalows. We have independent duplex bungalows at her, which is named like Kamyavan bungalows. We have three bungalows. So these are independent bungalows having duplex system and having, which includes two double bedrooms, luxurious and comfortable attached restrooms, then well furnished kitchen, and along with welcoming, spacious welcoming dining hall. So once you stay here, you will have a Swiss chalet experience. That also we are taking care. Next, please. So as far as precautionary measure is concerned, apart from the comfort and luxury, which we are taking care, we, and looking at the current scenario of COVID outbreak, this is the major concern, that we have made it mandatory for our staff that to stay inside the campus. So whatever staff which is going to serve our guest is staying inside the campus, and all the staff is also properly trained how to serve in the best possible way to our guest by maintaining these precautionary measures and safety norms. Next, please. This is also one of the advantage we offer to our guest, like you can take advantage of daily morning yoga session, which is being taught by trained yoga teacher, and the yoga session is being conducted in spacious halls wherein you can maintain your social distancing and other things. Next, please. So apart from that, we are also taking care of your health aspect, and for that we are providing, we are going to provide Ayurvedic kadha along with breakfast to our guest to boost up their immunity. So we are taking care of each and small aspect of that. Along with that, whatever relish food we are going to offer to our guest, that is being prepared by homemade spices, so as to ensure and so as to avoid any adulteration which in the spices which we take it from, if we take it from outside market. So this way we are committed to provide pure for food, which helps in improving the immunity of the guest. Next, please. Along with that, whatever food we offer, you can enjoy your dining and food in the spacious hall, which are cross ventilated properly, and you can enjoy it by maintaining social distance also. Also, after every meal, we are cleaning it and deeply sanitizing it with the help of our pest control team, so as to safeguard our guests. Next, please. This is one more USP what we have is, we have 24/7 in-house doctor facility. We have two doctors who stay inside the campus, and they are available 24/7. We also conduct regular medical checkups of not only our guest, but also our staff, so as to ensure their good health. Next, please. So apart from that, we also have ambulance facility, which is dedicated for Govardhan Eco Village, which includes two vehicles, ambulance vehicles we have. One is regular vehicle, and another one is cardiac ambulance facility, which we have, that is fully equipped, which is being provided to guests in case of emergencies. Next, please. Apart from that, as a precautionary measure, right now we have taken, management has taken a decision to keep aside one of our cottage to specifically defined, to make it defined quarantine facility, so as to handle any emergency situation, so that if any guests are developing symptoms, we keep them in isolation, and the dedicated special staff is there to serve them, to take care of them. Next, please. This is the ISO certification we have got. Govardhaniko village is having a centralized kitchen which have got ISO certification for maintaining the food safety management systems. So by way to maintain, so that we can provide quality, not only quality services, but also to ensure the purity and good services to the guest while providing the pure food to the guest. Next, please. Now coming to the package part, if we see now after unforeseen lockdown of 6 months, we are going to resume our operations from 1st of November. So we have come up with some special packages so that guest can take advantage of that. So special packages includes weekend package, weekday package. It is for 3 days and 2 nights for 2 persons. So weekend package will be like for 15,000 we offer, and weekday package will be for 12,000 for 2 persons. Then you can also have a Swiss chalet experience by staying at our luxurious duplex bungalows, independent bungalows, and the offered price of package is 25,000 for 2 packs. So all this package includes the stay cost of accommodation as well as the cost of food. We provide pure and sanctified food to the guest. Next, please. Apart from the general packages, what we have Govardhan School of Yoga, which is recognized, which is registered with Yoga Alliance, and which offers various courses for yoga training. So first is yoga teacher training course. It is like scratch to end total yoga, in-depth knowledge about yoga one will have, so as to get in-depth knowledge of yoga and for maintaining about his good health and good living. So the offer price for this package price is 64,000, and it is duration is for 31 days. Next is kids yoga teacher training course. It is of 10 days and at the rate of 20,000. So it is exclusively designed for parents and those who deal with the childs, who deal with the kids. Next is Gita and Yoga Sutra course. So this is based on the philosophical understanding of yoga with respect to Gita, which will also include theoretical as well as practical aspects of yoga with respect to Gita. So this is of 11 days duration, and at the rate of 22,000 we offer it. Then Yoga Nidra course. This is for self-regeneration. In 4 days, you will feel totally self-rejuvenated if you opt for this course, and the course fee is 8,000 rupees. So if you see to all these 4 courses, so basic, it is 2,000 per day, the cost which it will include accommodation cost of a single occupancy room in our Gokul cottage and non-AC room, and along with pure sanctified food. Next, please. So this is about our Ayurveda retreat center. We have well-equipped Ayurveda retreat center along with trained and very expertise Ayurveda Vaidyas. So we are offering some packages through our Ayurveda center also, like disease management package. It is starts from 91,200. Then weight loss package, which is the need of era now, which is cost at 80,500. And then immunity booster package, which is the need of the hour now. So it is cost at 77,000, and all packages are for 12 days duration. And in this, we offer this package cost includes the cost of accommodation in a deluxe or AC comfortable rooms, then the cost of food, pure Ayurveda food is being served, sattvic food is being served to the guest, then regular Ayurveda treatments along with regular consultation by the Ayurveda experts. So looking at all these, we have promised and we are committed to give you a wonderful experience wherein a guest, we are not only taking care of your comforts and only luxury, but we are committed to provide you a safe environment along with physical and mental good health. So this is all about what we offer from our Govardhan Retreat Center. This is all about us. Thank you so much. If you, we can start with video.
Rampant illiteracy, malnutrition, and lack of infrastructure. This is the story of WADA, one of India's most backward tribal areas. However, since 2010, ecotourism has become a lifeline for this region. Govardhan Eco Village's sustainable development model, which is based on harmony with the self, the environment, and the divine, has helped employ over 300 tribal families. More than 60,000 tribals have been provided free medical care.
$30,000
free meals are provided to school children every day. Over 60 bore wells have been installed. More than 300 families received training in organic farming. Govardhan Eco Village has transformed the lives of the most deprived communities in the world.
Eco Village is about 2.5. Govardhan Eco Village is about 2.5 hours northeast of Mumbai, in a very beautiful rural village area of Maharashtra. There's a very holy place in India which is considered most sacred to devotees of Krishna. It's called Vrindavan. And in that Vrindavan is a mountain named Govardhan, which represents environmental, ecological harmony with spiritual principles.
This place is very special. Certainly, it's unique in India and perhaps unique in the whole world. It's like a retreat center. It's like a spa. It's like an ashram. It's a place that's designed as an experiment to merge environmentalism, animal rights, and bhakti, spirituality, together, and it's working.
Come dance with me.
The amenities here are of a whole nother caliber. People, when they think of the words India and ashram, they think of harsh and rough living. From the Ayurvedic clinic, which not only gives treatments, but also has an Ayurvedic doctor who helps prescribe something that is specific for your dosha. The atmosphere that is created by the founder, Radhanath Swami Maharaj, and the atmosphere that is created by the devotees who work here is palpable. You can feel it in the air.
Originally, I was from Chicago. When I was 19 years old in 1970, I wanted to try to broaden my outlook of life. So I went on a journey. Ultimately, I hitchhiked from London to the Himalayas in India. And as I was traveling, I came to realize that the real social and environmental problems of the world are due to a spiritual crisis. A crisis in what we consider is actually meaningful and fulfilling in our life.
Radhanath Swami is a passionate person. The best passion is compassion, and he has an ample amount of that. And that type of passion is contagious.
Coming here and helping, you know, doing the save of the service, helping with the cows, helping with to weave mats, helping with make pottery. It's actually fun. It's a very simple lifestyle. And I think a lot of us crave that on different levels.
And it's sort of programmed into our culture that you look for recognition. You need it. For me being here, I see it's far more powerful to be humble.
It was easy to complain about the tiny inconveniences that come with a New York City apartment. Oh, it's not big enough. Oh, the water pressure isn't great enough. When you live in a house that you see built from the ground up, every step along the way is very special.
educational, experiential alternative of a fulfilling, meaningful, sustainable, healthy life.
Apart from these jasmine flowers which you're seeing, he grows a lot of these lady fingers, okra. Yeah. So we network with all these farmers so that we purchase them in our kitchen and use them.
Can we get this to the kitchen? No. We can give them to the, yeah.
And the inspiration of this project, Srila Prabhupada, he called this transformation simple living and high thinking.
We get 3,000 millimeters of rain annually. So the rainwater hits against those mountains, the Sahyadri mountain ranges, and flows down and collects here. And it is sufficient water for us to irrigate our fields for up to 6 to 7 months every year. The majority of India's population, which is 1.2 billion, lives in the villages. So one of the very important requirements to develop a village is how can water be conserved?
The process begins here. As you can see, the raw sewage is falling and there are some screens. The first chamber is called screen chamber, where we're trying to separate floating solids. This is the raw water where we began, and this is the treated water.
The uniqueness of this place comes from the fact that every waste is becoming a precious resource. That cow dung becomes a fertilizer for earth. He needs fire or energy for cooking his food, and therefore all of the cow dung is utilized for biogas plant. We need to make houses, so we use the same earth, and we have created 250,000 bricks. We call this a symbiotic recycling model. Flushing your toilet, you are contributing to the growth of a papaya. You are contributing to the growth of flowers.
One of the greatest management gurus says that the greatest management challenge of the 21st century is managing oneself.
Many corporate heads are having seminars and retreats here, and they also see alternative ways by which they could focus their own corporations and feel a real sense of responsibility to humanity.
The thing I'm most compelled to do when I get home is really a seva. It's service. It gets us out of being so self-absorbed.
I always had too much, and now I want to have a simple life, like here. I love simple life, and my goal is to make a simple life in my home.
And if we just refocus our energies with these values, we could transform the world.
Every step that I'm taking, you dance with me, you dance with me.
It's truly a miraculous, magical place on this planet.
Thank you, Prabhuji, and thank you, Mr. Vikas, for this amazing presentation, taking us to a journey. And, you know, it was very much, very appropriate for us on a day when we are celebrating the World Tourism Day with a theme globally, which is tourism and rural development. We saw a classic example of how an initiative has kind of transformed the lives of the villages around. And this is something which is appropriate for us to kind of all support and encourage in the coming days. Similarly, we also have some questions which have come in. In fact, there's a question about how to reach this from the Gujarat side, where you had mentioned that, you know, one can also come from the Gujarat side. We have the chairman of the Indian Association Tour Operator from Gujarat chapter, Randhir Singh Vaghela, who has asked this question. Maybe you can take this and reply how to reach this place.
Yeah, Vikas ji.
Yes. So when you come from Surat, sir, it is 10 Nakam will come before Mumbai. So you have to take a left and Hamrapur Fata will come. You have to go inside that, 13 kilometers inside that, Galtare village is there. So just besides Galtari village, our campus Govardhan Eco Village is there. So you have to take left from Gujarat, Surat Thane Highway, from Tennaka. Tennaka Junction will come. Under overbridge, you have to take a left, and then some 4-5 kilometers after, you will find an arch on right side. You have to take a right turn over there.
Thank you. And yeah. In fact, we have a request from several operators who have shared their emails, which yes. I have kind of recorded. I will share this with you so that the packages can be sent to them. Our ultimate objective is to facilitate travel and provide the best of experience in a safe environment, especially when we open travel after the pandemic. Of course, many of the destinations are open, and the trend is that there's a lot of weekend travel happening. So what better place than, you know, something which kind of spiritually regenerate and also give them a safe environment. And I'm also looking up some more questions if which we can take.
Yes, please. Yeah, we are happy to answer.
And also, if you have any e-brochures, people have requested for such e-brochures, maybe you can put it across to us.
We'll see that. Yeah.
In fact, there's one question. Who will be the driving force for this transformation? Should it be self-inspired process or government-driven? This question is from Mr. Mohanan.
Yeah. So I would like to share with you, Mr. Mohanan, that there are three things which are required. First is inspiration. Second is intelligence. And then based on inspiration and intelligence, when you have integrity also. So integrity, inspiration, and intelligence is the key to begin this process. If you do not have inspiration, you cannot last. If you do not have integrity, then things will not be used the way it should be. And if you do not have intelligence, then you will not know how to marry tradition to technology. So our advantage has been that we have kept the rural landscape rural only, but just done minimum intervention to create city comfort. So that requires some intelligence. How to give city comfort without compromising on the rurality of that place. So therefore, it has to come from individuals. Government can be a supporter, and you know, this is basically a model to show what individual. In fact, the previous tourism minister, Sri Jayakumar Saab Rawal, he had organized a lecture for me for all the district collectors of Maharashtra, where I presented this, and he said this is a great model for rural development, where we combine tourism to rural development. And considering India 600,000 villages, the opportunity for tourism is huge. So you just have to have the right concept to put together. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Well, Prabhuji, I think most of them are primarily requesting for information, which I will share with you. And once again, I thank you for taking time, agreeing to our request to present the Govardhan Eco Village to the tour operator fraternity, and also to create some awareness about the special offering that we have. It's really a hidden gem, and we hope in the coming days we will be able to kind of benefit from the Eco Village experiences. With this, I also like to thank Parul, our media partner from Safari Plus, who has handled the presentation on the technical side, and all the participants today who accepted our invitation and joined in. In fact, after seeing this presentation, I'm inspired to search for such examples which are across the Western India and showcase to the tour operators fraternity. In fact, thank you for inspiring again with this amazing presentation, and we hope we will very soon be visiting, and the place will be a welcoming tourist to experience the real sustainable and ecotourism in practice. Once again, I thank you and Vikas ji, and if you would like to have any closing remarks, please let us know and we can end the session after this. Thank you.
So I already shared my email ID and said, if you want, you know, to get more information on how to create more eco-villages in rural India. You know, we have all the technology available. We have all the information and experience. And if you are looking for, you know, tourism-related discussions, then Mr. Vikas, I've also shared his email ID. It is basically gm@ecovillage.org.in. And you can stay in touch with him for all these different tourism-related discussions and packages. And, you know, from my side, the final remarks is I invite each and every one of the tour operators who's attending today to visit the Govardhan Eco Village to have an experience. And Mr. Venkateshanji can facilitate such a trip. And then we would be happy to host all of them and then do something which will transform people in the city, remove the depression of the people, increase their inspiration, and also improve the economy in the villages. So it's a win-win situation. Join us in this win-win program. Thank you very much.
Thank you again. Thank you, Parul, and thank you the Team India Tourism who have been supporting me with organizing such events. And I wish you all a happy World Tourism Day, and I look forward to the restarting and rebooting of the industry quickly. Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna. So I just wanted to put a mark.
Yes, please.
Yes.
A very happy World Tourism Day to everyone. And thank you, India Tourism, for putting up such effort to putting this event across. I would request Prabhuji and Eco Village Tourism so they can create an awareness program, especially for the tourism industry, because this is something which is the need of the hour. And we as an travel agent or the media people or the travel trade partners need to establish this and make it more aware to the tourists who are coming in. So, as you have the packages for the tour, yoga and other thing, wellness thing, so you can have something related to this topic as well, sir.
Which topic? Tourism.
Yeah, putting sustainable tourism in such a way that what you are doing it, we can definitely have it as an education system.
Sure. I will have Mr. Vikas ji reach out to Mr. Venkateshan and yourself, and then you can advise us based on whatever we have to, in what way we should make presentation.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Yeah, we also have the chairman of the Indian Association of Tour Operators from Maharashtra, Ms. Vasuki, who has joined us today, and also we have a hand going, Mr. S.S. Rao. If you're around, you can unmute and speak.
So, I'll do it, sir. So Mr. Rao can speak now. Mr. Rao, you can unmute yourself.
Well, I think fine.
Okay.
Parul, let's reply to all the queries and we can send it across to the Mr. Vikas. And once again, thank you. And we end the session here now.
Yes. Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
Yes, Mr. Rao.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry. Mr. Gauranga Das, I'm thankful to you. We are face to face. Mr. Venkateshan has given me opportunity. And I heard your voice, and as well Vikas Purohit nicely explained. But my question is only this: when there are groups of we bring for this go, what is the village called? Govardhan Eco Village. Is there any discount for a group, maybe 10 and above, etc., where we
yes.
take the domestic tourism more in India? You see.
Yeah.
So, if there is any discounts, we can bring more and more groups of 10 and above, so that that will be very fine. Instead of, you know, even the senior citizen, most of them also would like to join, like your programs which you announced in this, which I heard about it. So that will be much better. More, most of 60 and above will be more interested than to join for weekdays or 10 days or 15 days like that. I think that if we work out, it will be very nice. Thank you.
Yes, thank you so much, sir, for your advice. And I think Mr. Vikas will be in touch with Mr. Vengadeshan.
Yes.
And together, you know, because Mr. Vengadeshan is in touch with all of you. So, whatever he advises, you know, he's like our tourism guru. So, you know, we will move forward with his advice.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Parul, Ms. Vasuki, our chairman of Maharashtra IATO, Indian Association Tour Operators, just unmute her so that she can just say concluding remarks. Yeah.
Namaste, Prabhu Gaurang Das Ji, and Namaste, Vikas Ji. Thank you, Mr. Venkateshan, for organizing such a fantastic presentation. Sir, we would like to reiterate the point that if you could have something on a workshop and if you have all your programs and plans to be shared, we will share it amongst all our members. Most of our members are present today. And sure, it is indeed enlightening because many people would like to replicate what you have done. So they will take your expertise in doing that. We have Mr. Pandurang Tawariji and all, like, they would love to recreate it. So we will definitely be stay connected with you, and thanks a lot. Thanks a lot, Mr. Venkateshan.
Thank you, Vasukiji. Thank you. Fine. And Prabhuji, with your permission and with permission of all the participants, we will end the session today.
Thank you.
And we'll stay connected on email and phone calls. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.